first off, who are you?
My name's Jacob Naasz.
What inspired you to get into this industry?
So for me, I've always had a passion for video games. I've played them since I was really young, and really sort of enjoyed it. So, you know, when it came time to figure out what I wanted to do to go to college, I decided I kind of wanted to go both art and computer science, just because I wanted somehow to get into working in video games. So, in the end, I ended up being, I'm now a game designer. I work as a game designer professionally, but then do independent development on the side just for fun and for hobby. So.
What is the strength? What is your favorite part of being an indie developer as opposed to being a designer at a AAA studio?
I really like the freedom to just sort of explore different ideas and to try things and to really just sort of go out there on a limb and be like, you know, what would it be like if you made, like, I don't know, a presidential dating sim? That'd be kind of fun.
Yeah, there's Hateful Boyfriend. Like,
yeah, exactly. Yeah. You know? I mean, if you can date pigeons, you can date presidents, right?
Yeah, I always wanted to date
Abraham Lincoln. Totally.
Abraham, oh gosh. The history is destroyed.
Yes.
What is the biggest challenge of being an indie developer?
I think that one of the biggest challenges is, you know, kind of having to monitor yourself and make sure that you stay motivated and, you know, and just keep working on your stuff and finish whatever it is that you start. You know, I know a lot of people have problems with picking up and never finishing a bunch of projects and stuff. So one of the things that I'm trying to make sure that I do is, you know, go all the way through with the project that I've got going now so that, you know, I can start the next one later rather than a bunch of, you know, stuff all kind of going at once.
Speaking of projects, what is the history of your projects that you've been working on, with name or credits?
So I worked, like I said, at a professional capacity as a game designer for, you know, a couple of years now. I've worked on games like Castleville.
Okay. Passionate.
And yes. And a bunch of, you know, small little mobile games that I did during college and stuff. And I now work for iStation, helping them develop educational software. But as far as, like, personal projects go, Space Trucker is the first one that I've ever really gotten to a point where I say, you know, okay, this is something that I'm going to finish. I'm going to push it through till the end and see where it goes from there. So.
And is that the game that you're showing off today?
Yes, that's great.
Now tell us about that game.
So Space Trucker is a local multiplayer game. Where your goal is to deliver crates to a similar colored planet, so they follow you kind of in a chain, and you have to deliver the last crate in your chain to the same colored planet. Because space truckers are lazy, they're not going to unhook a bunch of stuff and drop things off and reconnect them and all that kind of stuff. So it's a game where you're constantly kind of having to evaluate what's on the board versus what you have and where you are, and figure out kind of, okay, so I've got this string of crates, and if I pick up another green one, I'm going to get more bonus points because I have two green crates, but my friend also has that, so I need to make sure that I blast him or steal his crates or that kind of stuff. So it becomes this really kind of crazy, chaotic mess, a little bit kind of, you know, Smash Bros-like, or maybe something kind of like Towerfall or Samurai Gun or things like that, like some of the other local multiplayer games that are out there. But you know, just kind of a bunch of stuff sort of thrown in there too. So there's all kinds of things that happen. You know, space bats go flying by, or galactic unicorns appear, or, you know, all kinds of just fun, silly, crazy, zany things. So
what conventions besides industry giants have you considered showing off your games?
You know, this is really the first time that I've ever felt like I've had something worth showing off and stuff, so I'm still trying to kind of figure out what it is that I would want, you know, to show it off at, but I have considered going to other things, you know, like some of the anime conventions that are here locally, some of the other gaming stuff. I was out of state when Screw Attack was here in town, so I couldn't go. No, and I, like I said, I was really bummed when I found out when it was going to be and that I was going to be out of town, so
yeah.
Maybe next year.
They'll probably open up.
Yeah.
Or, yeah. What about as far as sort of, do you ever, when you ever get any trouble into making your indie game, do you ever like feel like you need to seek help like Kickstarter or?
Right now, because it's all just sort of hobby development, I really don't feel any kind of pressure to, really set a hard deadline for myself, or, I've got, got to figure out a way to feed myself sort of thing. That's not something that I have to worry about. So for me, that's not necessarily something I've considered, but if I were to take this on sort of full time, I would probably look into it and see about doing something.
Yeah. I guess there's only one sort of issue with the indie half of the gaming industry, and I think this could be same said with for films, but most of the time people tend not to pay attention to indie developers or indie film developers, and
that's fair. I think that a lot of times people look at video games in maybe sort of the wrong sort of context. I like to think of video games as art. And a lot of times, if you think about artists, a lot of people are going to be making a bunch of stuff and they're going to go sort of unnoticed for years, if not forever, kind of thing. And it is a very unfortunate thing that we live in a space where that sort of happens. I think that there are people and organizations that are really interested in trying to help that one. You've got things like the Indie Fund,
Dallas Society of Play.
Yeah, the Dallas Society of Play, or just local groups that are interested in promoting these games and these people. So a lot of times for indie developers, I think it's also important to remember that you can't just develop on your own. You have to engage with the community. You have to be kind of your own PR machine in whatever way you can. I don't know the situation involved with the game that you mentioned, but
And I don't either. But how do you, in particular, how do you feel like overcoming this challenge? How do you feel like getting Space Truckers notice and standing out of the bunch?
So, one of the things is, I think when I get to the point where I feel like I'm ready to really kind of go out there and try and start doing a bunch of, PR push and stuff for the game, I'll probably start hitting up Twitter, maybe contacting journalists, but also just being involved with, the Dallas Society of Play, and local gaming groups and stuff is something that I think definitely helps because, there are guys, Kyle J. Pittman, who, he's going to have a game on Steam here in October, and he's already got a group of people that, follow him and are interested in what he's doing. So leveraging contacts and things like that is another great way to do that.
Well, I think that wraps it up. Thank you for your time.
Yeah.
You can follow Jacob Naasz on Twitter at samaflange or go to pottedmonster.wordpress.com.